Hello and welcome back to Proactive New York. I'm Christine Corrado. With me right now is Guy Chamberland, CEO at Tetra Bio-Pharma. Guy, it's great to see you again. How are you?
I'm doing very well. Thank you for having us back, Christine.
Of course. A big milestone achievement for you as you have awarded the contract for the manufacturing of your drug product ARDS to Dalton Pharma Services. Can you maybe talk a bit about Dalton, who they are, why you just decided to choose them?
Dalton is an established GMP drug manufacturer. They have a very good reputation, have the experience it takes to develop a product like ARDS-003. It is an injectable product that has to be both sterile and obviously meet the formulation requirements to be able to administer it to a patient. And that's why we selected them.
And just remind us a bit about ARDS itself for investors who might be new to the story.
So the ARDS-003 is one of the, I guess, unique products out there that we're developing for the treating the cytokine release syndrome. So it's basically aimed at reducing, or say, squashing the hyperinflammation to prevent the sepsis and the ARDS, that the acute respiratory distress that will basically happen in patients exposed to COVID or other infectious diseases like influenza and even some other causes of sepsis that are known out there. So this drug, I say it's unique because most of the other drugs under development are what we call repurposed drugs. So they already have an established safety formulation exists. So you can just, you know, take it off the shelf type of thing and give it to a subject and nobody's worried about it. Just like hydrochloroquine, people weren't worried about it because it had a known safety profile. Our drug is brand new, it's unique. It's hundreds fold stronger than CBD and it's an oil. So, I mean, there's multiple challenges in bringing such a drug to the market.
And what's the advantage of the drug being delivered intravenously?
Well, for the intravenous route, we decided to target the hospitalized patients. So you come into the hospital, you have a lot of, I guess, pulmonary symptoms, probably difficulty breathing or heavy coughing, and we want to prevent them going onto the ventilation. The best way to administer is to give it intravenous, and you can get a high dose into the body fast. It'll go to the lung tissues. It'll also go to all of the tissues in the body. And that's the goal of preventing basically that hyper-inflammatory reaction. And intravenous is the best and most efficacious route of doing it. And it's simple in a hospital setting for a doctor to inject a drug.
So where are you at right now in the drug development pipeline with actually getting ARDS to commercialization?
So we just achieved a major milestone. And I know it's hard for people to understand because if you're not a drug developer, you don't really understand the challenges. But one of the key things, we have been doing our toxicology program like we announced. We've completed several studies and things are going well. There's no red flags that came up in the toxicology program. But one of the challenges is getting a formulation that you can actually give to humans. And it's a nano type of emulsion that's sterile. And like I said, it's an oil. So if I put oil in water, it's going to separate. I can't have that separate in your blood. So I have to find a way to really make it stable and be able to inject it. We have criteria, FDA, Health Canada, European agency, we all have standards of what a formulation needs to meet to be able to be acceptable for human use. And we finally achieved that. And with what we call the GMP manufacturing, which is a lot of standards. So this is a very significant milestone because it means on the manufacturing side, other than say completing scale-ups, validation types issues, from a formulation point of view, the drug is basically ready. So that was very significant. We were very, very happy. And that's why we decided, well, it's time to announce who we've been working with. We've been working with Dalton for close to a year on this product because it was also our ocular drug, but they were not working before on the injectable version, just for the formulation for the eye.
So what are the next steps here? Is there a certain amount that Dalton is manufacturing?
So the next step is they prepare the kind of, you could say, kind of a first scale up to manufacture the drug for the human trials. In there, obviously, we complete the validation studies that are required to file the IND, and that's going on schedule very well for us. We're very, very pleased. And then the next step is obviously in parallel, we're completing the dog and the rat studies that are required, but we needed also the human formulation for some of those tests. We need to see how it's really going to be tolerated and not just what we call the active molecule. The active molecule toxicology is well advanced. We also need to know how is a person going to respond when we inject this drug to them. And that's obviously now going to be able to start, which is very key in the safety studies.
Wow, Well, definitely a big congrats on these recent advancements. Guy, thanks so much for the time today.
You're welcome. My pleasure to be on your show.